Welcome to Next Gen Live. It is a joy to see you with us to study God's Word. We thank you for your comments and suggestions. We would like to also ask you to send us videos of how you were blessed by our program. Now today, we will start a brand new series called Obedience. And this series runs under church-wide campaign called Motivate for Families. Now let's open our time together with a word of prayer. Let us pray. Father God, thank you very much. Bless our time together. Fill us with your wisdom. Guide us with your spirit and teach us everything that we need to know. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Kids, what do you think is in the box? I will give you three clues. First, it is made of wood. Second, it can float on water. Do you now have an idea of what is inside our box? You need one more clue? Okay, let me give you the last one. You can ride in it. Do you know now the answer? Yes, you're right. It's a boat. And in our story, it's not just a boat, but a very large one. So do you now have an idea of what our lesson will be for today? So let's turn our attention to our lesson. Now, anyone who comes from the family of Adam, like Noah, bears the nature of sin. In principle, sin separates Noah from God, just like Adam. Sin simply means man has been disobedient to God. And God cannot stand sin because he is holy. And as a consequence to sin, Adam and his descendants had been turned away to that perfect place that was created by God and that was made for them to take care of. You and I are no different from Adam and Noah. That means we have been separated from God by sin as well. Like me, you may have taken something like a paperclip or even skipping a small chore like fixing your bed. These are some examples of sin. Now, in Noah's time, mankind has fallen deep into sin. Because of this, God decided to wipe out his creation. Now, what makes Noah different from the rest of us? Now, let's open our Bibles, turn to Genesis chapter 6, verse 9. Let us read together. These are the records of the generations of Noah. Noah was a righteous man, blameless in his time, and Noah walked with God. Wow! This is just amazing. Noah was found blameless and he was walking with God. For someone to be found blameless or righteous, he must have been very faithful to God. So how can we be like Noah? We should obey God no matter what. So how do we apply this at home? When you are given a simple task, do your homework, or something challenging like taking care of your brothers and sisters, you need to do it, even if your parents or guardian is not there to remind you, because it is written in the Bible that God commanded us to obey our parents and every authority that had been placed over us. So if your friends, your cousins, or siblings ask you to play with them, remember to stay faithful in finishing your tasks first. It is okay to say that you will join them after, or maybe when you are free next time. Now God gave Noah a big task. Noah has to build a very large ark, and it will take a very long time. It will require a lot of patience. The instructions of God are very precise in terms of measurements and its purpose. Let us open our Bibles again, and this time let us read from Genesis chapter 6, verses 17 to 19, and from verses 21 and 22. Behold, I am bringing the flood of water upon the earth, to destroy all flesh in which is the breath of life. From under heaven, everything that is on the earth shall perish, but I will establish my covenant with you, and you shall enter the ark, you and your sons and your wife, and your sons' wives with you. And of every living thing of all flesh, you shall bring two of every kind into the ark, to keep them alive with you. They shall be male and female. As for you, take for yourself some of all food which is edible, and gather it to yourself, and it shall be food for you and for them. Thus Noah did, according to all that God had commanded him, so he did. Our country have been through earthquakes, typhoons, and now with the widespread disease that have taken the lives of many. But these things are nothing compared to what God will do in our story. With the great flood, God has chosen to spare only one family, the family of Noah. For Noah to obey God, I would like to believe that it was made difficult because he knows that his friends, his neighbors, his relatives, and the rest of the world will perish because no one believes him, and they even ridicule him for building the ark. It's like this joke that I hear. People say, "Hey, why do you have an umbrella? It's all sunny and dry." Then came the rain, then the flood, then everyone is running to find shelter, and they are all wet. I too once got caught in the same situation because I decided to follow my own way. I don't have my umbrella, no raincoat, and I just like to walk. But at the end of the last verse that we have just read, Noah obeyed every command that God gave him. So like Noah, again, we should obey God no matter what. So how does our story end? Let us look at and read the last few verses from our story, from Genesis chapter 7 verse 1, verse 5, and verses 11 and 12. Then the Lord said to Noah, "Enter the ark, you and all your household, for you alone I have seen to be righteous before me in this time. I will send rain on the earth 40 days and 40 nights, and I will blot out from the face of the land every living thing that I have made." Noah did according to all that the Lord had commanded him. In the 600th year of Noah's life, in the second month, on the seventh day of the month, on the same day, all the fountains of the great deep burst open, and the floodgates of the sky were opened. The rain fell upon the earth for 40 days and 40 nights. God, being true to His word, He kept His promise to Noah because God found him to be righteous. The great flood is a reminder of what God will do. God shows grace to those that are found righteous in His eyes. But for those who remain disobedient, there will be consequences like those in the story of Noah. If you still find it difficult to do all these things, then let God motivate you to obey. You can do this by reading His word. There you will find God's instructions on how to please Him, His words that will encourage you even through tough times, and all His promises that you can hold on to. And that brings us to our main point for this week. Obey God no matter what. Again, obey God no matter what. In Noah's story, God looked down on the world and He saw that everyone are doing bad things. Because God is holy and He hates sin, He had to punish people for their wickedness. That punishment was death by the flood. But God found Noah to be righteous in His eyes. He believed God when He said that the flood is coming. And so Noah built the ark. God saved Noah and the rest of his family. But for the rest of the world, well, they were destroyed. There is a punishment for sin, and it's still the same from the day of Noah. And in our case, it's spiritual death. It separates us from God for all eternity. However, just like Noah, we have an ark. Our ark is Jesus. We need to get on board that ark. To do that, we need to accept the gift of salvation that Jesus offers us. If you would like to make that decision today, then pray this prayer with me. Let us pray. Father God, forgive me for all the things that does not please You. Forgive me for being disobedient. Lord Jesus, come into my life, be my Savior and Lord. Teach me Your ways. Help me become more like You. I pray all this in Your name. Amen. Now let us recite our memory verse from Genesis chapter 7 verse 5. Noah did all that God had commanded him. Obedience is sometimes hard, but it's not impossible. All you have to do is carry it out. Choose to obey God no matter what. Now, here are some questions that you can discuss with your families. Was there a time that you disobeyed God on purpose? What was the consequence? How did God protect and bless Noah because of his obedience to Him? Do you like to be blessed and protected by God? How can you obey God today? Were there times in your life where you disobeyed God? What did you learn from that mistake? Share your story where you chose to obey God even if it was difficult. How did God bless your obedience? What convictions will you pass on to your kids that will always guide them to obey God? Thank you for joining us. If you have been blessed by our program today, Send us your comments, like and share our posts, check out our other videos just for you. This is Teacher Morris reminding you to obey God no matter what. Again, obey God no matter what.